Welcome to the lecture series on design and analysis of algorithms. Today's lecture, let us understand what you mean by NP problems, NP complete problems, NP hard problems, and also the notations like P, NP, NP complete, NP hard, and so on. The discussion is purely different from the discussions that we have done in all our 5 modules. This discussion is we are explaining the complexity of the algorithms, polynomial time complexity of algorithms, and non-deterministic polynomial time complexity algorithms. Let us understand these terminologies in detail. It is observed that for many of the problems that we have studied, the best algorithms for their solutions have computing time falls into basically into 2 categories. Number one, the time complexity of the algorithms fall into the category of polynomial. That means, for example, binary search, it is big O of log n, linear search, it is big O of n, in general big O of n square, n cube, or n to the power k. So all these are polynomial in nature. It is observed that if the algorithm is in polynomial in nature, even though the n value increases, the solution is obtained in acceptable amount of time. Even though the time is large, it is quite acceptable. The another category the algorithms belongs to is their solutions are bounded by non-polynomials. For example, if you consider the traveling salesman problem, the solution, it is bounded by the time complexity of big O of n square 2 to the power n, where n is the total number of cities. So here we can observe that 2 to the power term is there, which is a non-polynomial term. So this fall into the category of non-polynomial. And also the knapsack problem, it is big O of 2 to the power n by 2. It is also non-polynomial time. So for this non-polynomial time complexity problems, as the time increases exponentially, even as the n increases, the time complexity increases exponentially. So even a moderate size problems, even the small value of n, it is very difficult to solve practically, because the time taken is very, very large, even for the small values of n. So far, no one has able to devise an algorithm which is bounded by a polynomial for a problems belonging to non-polynomial. So as far as time complexity is concerned, existing non-polynomial time algorithms, whatever is there, so far nobody found a polynomial solution for that. Nobody found polynomial time complexity based solution for that particular algorithms. However, the most important thing is that, not most interesting thing is that, the impossibility of such algorithm is also not proved. That means, for existing non-polynomial time algorithms, there is no polynomial time algorithm. This statement is not proved actually. So, is there exist a polynomial time algorithm for the solutions? As of now, we have non-polynomial time complexity that is not known to us. Okay, so since it is not known to us, we cannot say it is not there. We cannot say it is there. The only thing is that impossibility of such algorithm is not proved. So, we are in search of such algorithms, suppose it is possible to find out polynomial time complexity algorithm for, say, for a traveling salesman problem, definitely it is a breakthrough in history of design and analysis of algorithms. Now let us understand two more definitions. Turing machine, the Alan Turing has come out with some definitions: deterministic and non-deterministic computers. So what do you mean by deterministic and non-deterministic computer? A deterministic computer is a model, is a computer that usually we can think of. The basic idea is that the execution happens in sequential fashion, and every operation is uniquely defined, and there exists a different deterministic algorithm for the execution. So that is what a deterministic computer means. The regular computer, whatever we are having, where the operations happens sequentially with the limited time, with the particular algorithm, we say that it is a deterministic algorithm. The another definition is a non-deterministic computer. Non-deterministic computer is the one that is just like we are used to, except that it is unlimited parallelism. So that anytime you come to a branch, you span a new process and examine both the sides. Non-deterministic computer is the one, it is a theoretically relevance, practically does not exist. Means it can execute parallelly number of processes at a time. So when the outcome is not uniquely defined, but it is limited to the specific set of possibilities, we call it non-deterministic algorithm. So it executes in a non-deterministic manner, where whenever the branches happens in the process, they are not further interacting with each other. The output will be given by any of the branches of the algorithms, which is executing parallelly. The another definition that is required for us in this discussion of NP complete, NP hard, that is nothing but decision problems as well as optimization problems. Or we can also say that decision versus optimization algorithms. What do you mean by an optimization algorithm? We have seen so many algorithms that belonging to this particular category. There exist several solutions, and optimization problem tries to find the optimal solutions. So among the several solutions, we need to find out the best one. This is about the optimization algorithms. Coming to the decision problems, the problem is trying to answer yes or no question. Yes or no question. So most of the problems can be specified in decision and optimization versions. For example, the statement says that any problem that is an optimization problem, we can have some equivalent decision problem, and vice versa. For example, traveling salesman problem can be stated in two ways. As a decision problem, we can say that there is a Hamiltonian cycle of weights with less than k. Please understand, Hamiltonian cycle is nothing but it is a complete path of the traveling salesman. He starts from the source city, visits all the cities exactly once, and comes back to the source. So that particular cycle, complete cycle, we call it as a Hamiltonian cycle. Now the traveling salesman problem can be stated as a decision problem, like trying to finding the answer for is there is a Hamiltonian cycle of weight or length less than or equal to some distance, let us say k. This is the decision version of traveling salesman problem. Now coming to the optimization version of the traveling salesman problem, it is to find the Hamiltonian cycle of minimum length or minimum weight. So that is the optimization problem. So we, in our discussion earlier, we come across the optimization problem, and we can state it as a decision problem, something like this. So please understand, every problem, every optimization problem can be stated as a decision problem and vice versa. Another example for this concept is graph coloring problem. So graph coloring problem, we can state it as an optimization problem, as find the minimum number of colors needed to color the vertices of a graph so that no two adjacent vertices are colored with the same color. As we have seen in the beginning of this particular module, so graph coloring is nothing but we need to color the graph actually. So each region is represented by a node. Suppose if you consider the geographically map, each region is represented by a node. So in the map, if two regions are adjacent to each other, there is an edge in the graph. So ultimately we are representing a graph. So we need to color the nodes of the graph such a way that adjacent two nodes should not have the same colors. And we need to, of course, there are several number of solutions we can give, but we need to find the minimum number of colors needed to color the vertices of the graph, having the constraint is met. So this is about the optimization problem. Coming to the decision version of it, we can say that whether there exists such a coloring of the graph of vertices with no more than say m colors. M we need to fix. So this is the decision version of it. So please understand, many optimization problems can be recasted into decision problems with the property that the decision algorithm can be solved in polynomial time if and only if the corresponding optimization problem. So this is the most important thing. Any optimization problem can be stated as a decision problem provided the decision algorithm is solved in polynomial time. The decision algorithm can be solved in polynomial time only if the corresponding optimization problem also can be stated in polynomial time. The what is the understanding here is, if one problem is say optimization problem, the time complexity is say polynomial time, then for the decision version of that particular problem, that is also we can get it in polynomial time. Suppose the optimization version of a problem is non-polynomial, exponential one, factorial one, then corresponding decision problem also is in non-polynomial time. So that is what the basic understanding. Now let us understand some more definitions, something called as P and NP. What is P? P basically stands for polynomial time. Polynomial time. Now, definition of the P, it is nothing but P is a set of all decision problems solvable by deterministic algorithm in polynomial time. So definition P is nothing but a decision problem, set of all decision problems solvable by deterministic algorithm in polynomial time. Please understand, this deterministic algorithm, the definition comes from the deterministic computer where sequentially it is executing, and this is executed in polynomial time. That is what P means. NP stands for non-deterministic polynomial time. NP doesn't stands for non-polynomial. NP stands for non-deterministic polynomial time. It is also polynomial time, but it is non-deterministic in nature. So NP is a set of all decision problems solvable by a non-deterministic algorithm in polynomial time. So non-deterministic algorithm means algorithm can execute in parallel and then does not communicate to each other, each of the parallel processes. It is observed that the set of problems coming under P, it is a subset of NP problems. So in other words, we can say that P is a subset of NP. So problems known to be in P are trivially belongs to the NP. So this is what our understanding. Further, more details on this. So P is a complexity class that represents the set of all decision problems that can be solved from that polynomial time. These explanations are taken from the Stack Overflow. Hope this explanation will make us a better understanding of P as well as NP. So P is a complexity class that represents the set of all decision problems that can be solved in polynomial time. That is, given an instance of the problem, the answer is yes or no can be decided in polynomial time. The examples are like, given a connected graph, graph coloring problem, whether its vertices can be colored using two colors, M is given as 2 now, whether the vertices of the graph can be colored with two colors so that no edge is monochromatic, means the vertices of a particular edge does not share the same color. So this is one polynomial time complexity algorithm. So algorithm starts with the arbitrary vertex, color it red and all its neighbors with blue and continue. Stop when you run out of the vertices or you are forced to make an edge that have both of its endpoints be the same color. So this is algorithm that fall into the polynomial time and it will answer this particular question. It is a decision problem. So this is one example of the polynomial time complexity problem belonging to the class of P. Coming to NP, it is also taken from the Stack Overflow. So NP is a complexity class that represents the set of all decision problems for which the instances where the answer is yes have proof that can be verified in a polynomial time. This means that if someone gives an instances of the problem and a certificate, sometimes called the witness, to answer is being yes, we can check that it is correct in a polynomial time, but the computation takes place in a non-deterministic algorithm. The example for NP problem is a integer factorization problem. So this is a problem that given integers n and m, to check whether is there is an integer f in between 1 to m such that f divides n or f is a small factor of n. So this is a decision problem because the answer is yes or no. So if someone hands us an instance of the problem, so they hands us integers n and m and an integer f which is less than m and claim that f is a factor of n, we can check the answer in polynomial time by performing the division n by f. But there are some problems, most interestingly, there are some problems which are known to be in the NP, but we don't know if they are in P class. Some examples are like, the example is decision version of traveling salesman problem. It is not known to us whether the decision version of the traveling salesman problem is in P. there is no known polynomial time solution, but there is no proof that such a solution does not exist. This is the most important thing. Please remember, P is a subset of NP. So there exist some problems in NP that is that does not belongs to P. That does not belongs to P, that doesn't mean that there is no corresponding solution in P. The only thing is that we don't know whether it belongs to P. That is the basic thing actually. There is no proof also that solution is does not exist. So some of the problems in NP may belongs to P. Okay, but we cannot say that. We don't have both the proofs. Whether it belongs to or does not belongs to, both the proofs are not with us. So most famous unsolved problem in computer science as of now, even now, is whether the class of problems belongs to P is equal to NP, or class of problems belongs to P is not equal to MP. So this is a famous unsolved problem in computer science. Moving further, let us understand few more definitions. Reducible problems. Given decision problems P and Q, two decision version of problems P and Q, if an algorithm can transform a solution of P into a solution of Q in polynomial time, it is said that Q is polynomial time reducible, or just reducible to P. There exist two problems P and Q. If there exist an algorithm that transform the solution of P into Q in polynomial time, we can say that Q is polynomial time reducible. The definition goes like this. The definition of NP complete goes like this. Non-deterministic polynomial time complete. A decision problem D is said to be NP complete if it belongs to the class of non-deterministic polynomial time, or NP, and every problem in NP is polynomially reducible to some D. So this is the definition of the NP complete. NP complete is a, of course, from the Stack Overflow, a few more understandings. NP complete is a complexity class which represents the set of all problems X in NP for which it is possible to reduce any other NP problem Y to X in polynomial time. Means it is reducible in polynomial time. Such a class we are calling it as a NP complete. It means that we can solve Y quickly if we know how to solve X quickly. Precisely, Y is reducible to X. So if there is a polynomial time algorithm F to transform instances of Y to instances of X, which is X equal to F of Y in polynomial time, with the property that the answer to Y is yes if and only if the answer of f of y is yes. So this is the explanation from the Stack Overflow. So informally, these are the hardest problems in the class of NP. So if any NP complete problem can be solved by a polynomial time deterministic algorithm, then every problem in NP can be solved by a polynomial time deterministic algorithm. But till date, no polynomial time deterministic algorithm is known to solve any of them. So this is about the description or explanation with respect to the NP complete. Some examples for the NP complete problem is CNF satisfiability problem. CNF satisfiability problem deals with the Boolean expressions. It is given by Cook in 1971. The CNF satisfied satisfiability problem asks whether or not one can assign values true or false to variables of the given Boolean expression in its CNF form to make the entire expression true. This is a problem of discrete mathematics where it says that whether or not one can assign the values true or false to variables of the given Boolean expression in its CNF normal form to make the entire expression true. So this is a problem called a CNF satisfiability problem. So this is an example of NP complete problem. There are many other problems belongs to NP complete: traveling salesman problem, decision version, Hamiltonian cycle problem, Kling problem, finding the subgraph in the graph Kling problem, subset problem, Boolean satisfiability problem, and many other problems are belonging to NP complete. The another set of problems called as NP hard problems. These problems need not have any bound on their running time. If any NP complete problem is a polynomial time reducible to a problem X, that problem X belongs to NP hard class. All NP complete problems are also NP hard, or in other words, NP hard problem is non-deterministic polynomial time solvable. It is a NP complete problem. Example of NP problem that is not NP complete is halting problem. So the overall the Venn diagram can be represented something like this. Already we have seen a set of problems polynomial time, we call it as P, and non-deterministic polynomial time we call it as NP. There exist some problems in non-deterministic polynomial time, but it is NP hard. We call it as NP complete problems. Other than that also there exist some other problems. We call it as NP hard problems. So this is the commonly believed relationship between P, NP, NP complete and NP hard problems. If a NP hard problem can be solved in a polynomial time, if you take from a NP hard problem, if it is possible to solve in polynomial time, then all the NP complete problems can be solved in the polynomial time. So in other words, all NP complete problems are NP hard, but not all NP hard problems are not NP complete. Of course, more readings, self-readings are required from the various literature to understand these concepts. So NP complete problems are subclass of NP hard. The more conventional optimization version of a traveling salesman problem for finding the shortest route is NP hard, not strictly NP complete. From the Stack Overflow, there are few explanations. I will just read it out. NP hard problems intuitively, these are the problems that are at least as hard as NP complete problems. Note that NP hard problems do not have to be in NP, but they do not have to be decision problems. More precise definition here is that a problem X is NP hard if there is an NP complete problem Y such that Y is reducible to X in polynomial time. One example is given here, that is a halting problem. The halting problem is NP hard problem. That is the problem that given a program P and input I, will it halt? This is the problem, halting problem. This is the decision problem, but it is not in NP. So let us understand what is this problem. Given a program P and given an input P, we need to come out with an algorithm such a way that given these two, whether it will halt or not at some point of time, or it will be there in the infinite loop. So this is what the halting problem is. So this is a decision problem to say that halt or not, yes or no. This is a decision problem, but it is not in NP. It is clear that any NP complete problem can be reduced to this one. So as another example, any NP complete problem is NP hard. Thank you. By this we complete 5th module. So all 5 modules are completed. Thank you.